Welcome back to WUCF's American Graduate Day celebration. I'm Annetta Wilson. Many teachers that work in Title I schools do not reside in the same area that their students live. Hear from the principal who took one of Orlando's failed high schools and what she did to take it to the top.
You've taken Jones High School, which has struggled academically, but you have successfully transitioned that into higher standards. What were some of the challenges that you faced to help that school?
I think one of the greatest challenges that was there was you had to really constantly instill in the students that they could do it, that they could be anything that they wanted to be, and accept no excuses. When they said they couldn't do it, you had to keep giving them that motivation that they needed, making sure that they had the things that they needed within the classroom, making sure that they attended tutoring. It was just, you had to be as persistent and relentless on them that they could do it and they will do it, so that they could wake up and all of a sudden they would say, wow, you know, I did it. So you just, persistence.
That's sounds like a culture kind of change, which
yes.
is a very difficult and long range kind of thing to do. You've been successful in a short time. How has Jones High School progressed from an F school, a D school, now to B grade status? That's awesome.
Consistency, focused on what needs to be done within the classroom, and again, allowing no excuses, making sure that the teachers have what they need to be successful, and having a team to embrace the route, the vision in which you're going. And sometimes you take some lumps and some bruises along the way, but you just have to know, stand.
You talk about your team. I was reading about some partnerships. How important are partnerships or even mentorships? Because I know that you work with the children as well.
Yes. Partnerships and mentorships are awesome. Students need to be able to see other people that look like them, that are successful, for those people to really put their arms around them and show them that you can do it because of my experiences. The 100 Black Men have been very instrumental in working with the students, taking them on different educational field trips, and just surrounding the students with positiveness.
How helpful that must be for the students to see firsthand and have both of you as examples. I understand that the staff and faculty periodically tour some of the neighborhoods that zone students into Jones High School. What's the purpose with this?
That's very important. The majority of the faculty do not live in the community. So you have to understand where the students come from to be able to help them to be successful in the classroom. Not that we're going to allow that to be an excuse, but it's very important. So yes, we load up a bus at the beginning of the school year and we take them to the different areas. And it's a very eye-opening experience because a lot of the members really did not understand from whence the students had come from.
With the teachers who take these trips and that, do you get the positive feedback?
Oh yes, the teachers usually have to write a reflection about the experiences. And I've had even teachers to say that they were really reluctant to go because they wanted to stay back in their classrooms and prepare for the students. But they thought that it was the best thing that they could have done, and they were glad that it was non-negotiable that they attended.
How significant is Jones High School to the Black community?
Jones High School is that light on a hill that shines pretty brightly. With the graduates from Jones High School that have a long history of being successful, not only here in Orlando, but all across this great nation. Admiral David Brewer, Dr. Sylvester Gates at MIT, Dr. David Henson, who is the president of Alabama A&M, and another long list of individuals. So it's that light that tells students, they did it, you can do it. They did it under adverse situation. You don't have that adversity that they had to face. And if they did it, you can do it.
Stay with us for the final hour of American Graduate Day here on WUCF-TV.